The Timbersaw is banned, so they read that as a problem from last game, and they won't be going up against that this time. Secret actually banned out the Darkseer themselves this time, given that Danish Bears had first pick, so we'll see what they start with. The Phoenix did get a lot done in lane, but late game, that egg, the Phoenix was so underleveled that the egg was basically useless in the fights, and Secret, I think, will be just fine going up against this hero if they can have the strong laning start that they did last game. And they'll be relatively happy. And the Venge first pick from Secret, they're on the Dire. This is potentially an ability to take the Roshan early, as Team Secret always do favor that Roshan advantage. We'll see what they do with this first pick. But yeah, and I mean, as you're talking about, if Team Secret win this game, they're through to the regionals, which, I mean, it's kind of like you're playing for the chance to go through probably one of the most stacked qualifiers in all of the four regions right now. Maybe China, the other option, but
Team
there's a
Secret. We are not holding back here. Diving straight the hell in. He wants that Terror Blade, but that gives Danish Bears four picks to draft around it.
That's... Second pick. Good
that's
lord.
A Team Secret kind of just not holding their cards to their chest, just throwing their cards across the room. Like, Terror Blade revealed this early. I mean, the only thing I'm thinking here is... No, it's too crazy here. Venge picked up Terror Blade with the Metamorphosis. Do you think this could be a very peculiar Drow strat?
Unlikely.
Yeah, it's really out there.
Terror Blade with Metamorph, I believe, does get the Precision Aura, but you don't really need to go Drow when you got a Terror Blade. Like, he pushes towers on his own just fine. And putting the Drow mid is just such a risky choice, especially against the Earth Spirit Phoenix. A lot of rotation potential, although, I mean, last game, they had these heroes they didn't rotate once. So maybe they move around on the Earth Spirit and the Phoenix a little bit more this time. But yeah, I mean, Team Spirit Secret with this pick, it's kind of like they're in game two. They know they've got a backup game if this goes south. So it's like, we'll pick the Terror Blade early and dare you to find a way to counter it.
Yeah, I mean, clearly it's something Team Secret are very comfortable with. We saw EE playing out of his mind in game one. He had a little bit of trouble getting rolling, but once he started, boy, he did not stop shredding apart buildings with no remorse. So, you know, Team Secret, they still got three more picks here. They need their mid, they need their secondary support, they need their offlaner. So there's a lot of hate. Danish Bear is just basically banning out Team Secret's lineup.
Banning out the Coddle. I mean...
That's really desperate.
The problem against Team Secret is that their hero pools are so deep, it's almost impossible to ban against them. Oh, a Meepo ban. Radiant
team. Wow. Are we cheesing here? What's happening?
I mean, I've watched a lot of Danish Bears. I don't think they have a Meepo player, unless Baby Knight plays a ton and I just haven't noticed.
No, I mean, their position one, their big heroes on Ace are Anti-Mage, Timbersaw, and Clockwork, as he used to play offlane there for Danish Bears before they shuffled around. And Baby Knight, he likes his Ember, he likes his Shadow Fiend, he likes his Lina. Meepo is not really first on the books. I mean, maybe they're thinking Danish Bears are so desperate, they just jump in for this and they go all in with the Meepo strat. Because Meepo, I mean, he can dunk on you if he gets enough, but it seems like even with Team Secret's lineup already, they're not going to have a tough time dealing with what could have been a Meepo. I don't know, this might just be disrespect from Secret.
Yeah, maybe they're worried that, maybe they're saying to themselves, the only way we lose here is if we get cheesed, so we'll ban out potential cheese heroes. Maybe they fifth ban the Huskar as well, but yeah, it's a little bit of an odd choice. And Danish Bears, they're taking out the Beastmaster, so there's two Bulba heroes down this time. Easily go for the Nyx again. It's still really strong against both the Phoenix and the Earth Spirit.
Team Secret, they definitely know how to play this draft. They got Pilot Eye on the Venge. They got EE on the Terror Blade. Why not pick up Bulba on the Nyx once again? It comboed so well. And you've got heroes that kind of fill the same role as the Keeper of the Light. They can kind of chase you down. They can tag you out. So I don't think the Coddle ban is too problematic here at all.
Exactly. There's so many heroes the Puppy could play here that would have the similar impact. So really... hard to ban against them. That's just what it comes down to. And you can see that in there. Maybe you can do it if you just focus ban one person. Like if you just straight up ban every single puppy hero you can think of. But they're not doing that either. They're kind of splitting it up. A couple of puppy heroes, a Bulba hero. So you're not going to ban out any one person on Team Secret's hero pool. Maybe you make them play something that they're slightly less comfortable with this lineup. But even so, okay, it'll be a bat.
All right, I do like the bat here. I mean, has the potential to be mid. I'm going to think probably more of an offlaner here as he can just dip out and jungle kind of easily. Team Secret still have a lot of flexibility to see what Danish Bears are going to put up in the mid. They don't have to make that decision just yet.
Yeah. My guess is that it's offlane, but
yeah. I mean, it's not really an RTZ hero, and Terrorblade is definitely an EE hero.
Yeah, I'll have to see. And Danish Bears, with this aggressive dual support, I really want to see them pick a strong safe laner who can be left alone so they can actually move around this time. Again, you've got the potential to punish that Terrorblade, and if they read that last game right, they really should be going for that this time, I think. And maybe Team Secret looks to get Funky switch the lanes up to try and keep their TB safe, but if Danish Bears just play passively, then this is going to heavily favor Secret once again.
Absolutely. I mean, Team Secret, we saw them kind of, again, not really drop the ball in the early game as they did have a more of a late game oriented lineup anyways, but they didn't start out with a very commanding presence. And speaking of commanding, holy hell, Danish Bears, they're all in for this, and they absolutely need to be. And this means Danish Bears have to rotate in such a cohesive group. They cannot afford to lose duels here. Every single time they make an initiation, they've got to get the kill.
10 seconds remaining. The Legion Commander, a nice response to the Batrider, because of course Press the Attack does purge off the lasso. But Legion Commander, one of those heroes that you're kind of all in on. If you don't have a good lane, if you don't get that dual damage up, then you can really struggle to contribute. Now the other nice thing about it is that Overwhelming Odds is nice against Terrorblade because he's going to have all those illusions up. Puppy, though, goes back for the Enchantress.
Yeah, I mean, this is just such a puppy comfort hero. He's going to rotate around very effectively. So the support duo going to be Puppy Enchantress, Pylite Eye Venge. So much mobility, so much control. They can definitely rotate around as a group, as solo heroes. We'll see what Team Secret are going to do with that. And the Danish Bears, they've got 2 more picks to go up against this very strong draft from Secret. It's feeling kind of desperate here.
Yeah, all right. So Legion Commander, I'm wondering where they run her. Because Baby Knight does play this hero mid. So it could be the Legion Commander mid. And if that's the case, you've got some decent kill potential there with the rotations of their supports. And then you're looking for an offlaner and a safe laner. So also Legion, not super gankable. Enchantress, if he comes in with those creeps, you just Overwhelming Odds, you got the movement speed to run away. It's really easy to get out of dodge if you're in trouble. So this is going to be a strong lane for Legion. And if they can get a lot done with it, then okay, a Death Prophet. Never
yeah,
mind.
So that's going to be more of a typical mid. I mean, they could throw Legion mid, Death Prophet safe. That doesn't really maximize your effectiveness in the lane, so I'm assuming it's going to be nothing too fancy.
So an offlane Legion, then. Interesting. I mean, it's punishable, unless they want to just straight up jungle it, which they could do. Legion Commander, Iron Talon, jungle? Are we pubs now, boys? It's the possible play. Because I feel like Legion Commander is a little too easy to shut down in the offlane. And if she doesn't have a good start, if she doesn't get that early blink dagger, she really struggles to come online.
Yeah, I mean, she could dip into the jungle for easy levels, and that would mean that Batrider gets kind of a free lane if he is in the offlane. So we'll see what Danish Bears are going to do to maximize their effectiveness, because again, they've got a set portion of the map they can work with, and with a Terrorblade, that set portion is going to rapidly shrink.
Yeah, we'll wait and see how it goes. But okay, Tideban from Team Secret, not wanting to deal with the Ravage, another potential counter to the Batrider initiation of the Blink Lasso. And it has to be said, they don't actually have a lot of immediate follow-up to the lasso. They don't have a huge amount of burst damage other than just Terrorblades, right clicks, and metamorph, which can be considered burst damage in its own right. But you don't have immediate kill, and against this particular lineup, you're against heroes like Earth Spirit, who if he survives can roll away, Phoenix with the dive, Legion Commander with the purge, and Death Prophet with the soul siphon. So I wouldn't mind seeing the mid hero, which I'm assuming it is from Team Secret, having some kind of burst potential to combo with the Batrider. Of course, you can just go for the lasso as control and not worry about taking a hero out of the fight immediately, but that's kind of what Batrider's for. Oh boy.
Team Secret. So Danish Bears, no holds barred here.
Offlane Sand King.
Offlane Sandking. I think that's going to get a lot of levels. It's going to level up very quickly, and they do bring a lot of control to these team fights. If you get the Legion Commander with that duel, with that lockdown, I mean, it is good damage going to the Legion, but it's also just holding someone in place for the amount of time it takes to channel up that epicenter and rip them apart. So Danish Bear is bringing in a lot of damage, but Team Secret, I think they've got enough to weather the storm here. Their last pick is going to determine a lot. I think it's going to be a mid Quap banned out against them. Puck is still in the pool, but I don't think that gives enough team fight oomph.
Yeah, and I would really be interested to see if Danish Bears run an aggressive tri-lane here.
Oh, they're going with the Invoker, which has made it through all the way through the ban phase. So definitely going to be interesting here. Baby Knight will be playing the Death Prophet, so it is going to be that safe lane Legion like we talked about offlane. And Sand King, and I mean, I'm very excited for this game to get underway. Again, the stakes are huge for this. If Team Secret win, they're into the regional qualifier. If Danish Bears drop this, if they lose, they are right back to square number one, competing again in those eight best of ones to grind their way back up the EU region. Everything's on the line here.
Yeah. Now, I really do want to shout out the potential of a Legion Commander aggressive tri lane here. They can run Hestajoe in the safe and just pressure the Terrorblade with a Legion, a Nurse Spirit, and a Phoenix. Those three heroes are a terrifying aggressive tri-lane. And Legion with the overwhelming odds, that is one of the best tri-lane spells in the game. And if they want to shut down the Terrorblade, that could be a really nice way of doing it. Now, it is a little risky. Aggressive tries always are, but again, to EE's Terrorblade, I think that might be the play.
All right, we are loading in here what could be the last game of the EU Open qualifiers for today. Again, tomorrow we start all over again with all the hopefuls grinding their way up from the trench with those six best of ones going down. Again, the 23rd, that's going to be right here on Beyond the Summit 1 with Llama down under casting the EU region, and I'll be casting on Beyond the Summit 2. But for now, we are going to finish off the grand finals. Again, winner of this series does move on to the regionals. Their spot. Now we can go ahead and introduce the teams here. On the side of Danish Bears, we've got Baby Knight on the Death Prophet, Ace going to be playing up the Legion Commander, Hestajoe, Rotten on that Sand King, Noya going to be going in on the Earth Spirit, and Rise on the Phoenix.
We got a smoke plate. Yeah, the stream just went down. Is that a problem that's already been fixed because of the delay, or do we need to get on that?
It's completely fine on my end.
Okay, maybe I'm just wrong.
No, I think it's something going down here. I'll wait for production to tell me, but I am not dropping any frames for now, so we'll see if something gets worked on. So for right now, just waiting to see what happens.
It looks like the smoke play did not result in any potential kills. Eternal Envy will be just fine. They don't run into anyone, and they do scout out as Danish Bears walk away. The battle okay, begins. Looks like the stream's back.
All right.
False alarm. We're good.
Okay, there we go. Sorry about that, guys. Again, there is a big delay on Twitch right now just because of the way the input's working. So we are casting from a bit behind. So chat, unfortunately, had to deal with that. We did not know about the problem. We apologize. Well, hopefully we're back now and there's no more issues moving forward.
Yeah, and already an invade from Danish Bears, Rise, and Noya moving into the enemy jungle, but Puppy will scout them out, and they won't be able to move onto the mid of Arteezy.
They're going in. They get the stun here onto Rise. Rise flapping away. May have to scale up the Icarus dive. Will scale up the Icarus dive. That means no Sunray level 1, and Phoenix might start for level 2 here. Now in the mid lane, there's hardly going to be trees abundant as Baby Knight goes through. Will actually snap up Invoker's Iron Branch tree. A little bit of cheeky plays.
I think that was his. Arteezy still has both his branches, so I'm pretty sure that was Baby Knights. Maybe he was just trying to bait him. I don't know.
Okay. Either way, getting quirky there is down bottom. We are going to have Bulba going in for that offlane bat, and there is going to be that jungle legion. Well, not solely jungle legion. She's going to hop into lane for some nice XP, but has a lot of map to work with, and you called it out there. There is going to be that aggressive try over here.
But not
for
with
Danish
the legion,
Bears.
Though.
But
that
they still
is
have a lot of
kill
potential.
Oh, sure. And it's still a good lane. But Legion, with the overwhelming odds, is just such a natural tri-lane hero that it seems a little odd to me. Still, Hestajoe can do a lot in this lane as well. And this means that Sand King, with a lot of farm early, can have a huge impact in the game. So if he can actually find that farm, he'll be in good shape.
Alright, now EE on the Terror Blade, he's going to get a bit more contest here. I think Danish Bears learned their lesson, and they're not going to give away a free lane to the Terror anymore.
Yeah. Good for them. Also, the lane for Danish Bear's bottom, the safe lane with the Legion, is actually very favorable because she can just use press the attack to purge off any napalm stacks. So Bubba really has a hard time going on her. Normally, a solo lane against a melee hero would favor the bat, but not in this case.
All right, so moving forward here, again, this mid matchup is going to be Death Prophet Invoker, very classic here. Arteezy getting a lot done in terms of last hits, but they're matched up. I mean, Baby Knight going to be going through now with that Soul Siphon, getting Arteezy a little bit low. This could be the roll in, but nice tornado, crazy reaction speed from Arteezy. It eats up all his mana, but secures him getting out alive.
Yeah, we'll be just fine, and Baby Knight cancels the salve, so that's a little bit unfortunate, but Arteezy is still doing all right in this lane. I mean, as a Quas Wex Invoker, you don't expect to be able to stay even on last hits with a Death Prophet, but he's doing so for now.
Yeah, I mean, he's definitely got those fast fingers like we talked about. He's going to be going for Phase Boost first, which I do like. He's going to get that extra chase potential if he needs it.
Yeah. Now, there is another rotation into mid. Puppy trying to keep Arteezy safe, as he does have someone sitting behind him, but Noya will just back off. And Arteezy, for now, doing just fine. The Legion farming up very well, though. Uncontested, has the best last hits in the game. Arteezy doing all right, but sitting a little bit behind, so not having as great a start as he did last game.
All right, up top, this could be a rotation here. Has the Terror taking a magic pistol to the face. There's going to be Terror Blade going with Metamorphosis, and that's going to be the first blood here as Eternal Envy already starting strong. It costs him a lot there. He has to use his full kit to get it on, but that's going to be a very dead Sand King. And, you know, it's not the most crucial kill in the world, but it's something. Now, Arteezy, he's going to get stunned up. They could look for the trade here. They're going to rotate in a lot. They bring in the Phoenix Icarus dive around. They're going to get the bird damage here. Arteezy getting very, very low. He casts up the Cold Snap, but not able to get Noya down. He's going to be zip zapping a few times, but that's going to be Arteezy down. It's a 1-1 score, but definitely Invoker the bigger loss there.
Getting first blood gold on Envy is just fine too, though. I'm not sure Secret are going to be too sad about that turnaround. Do you expect at least some ganks to be successful from Danish Bears? They've got such good roaming supports. So, I mean, a couple deaths are more or less inevitable against this lineup. Baby Knight, though. Okay, just taking some harass. Arteezy can't finish him off. No backup.
Yeah, it's completely fine. It's going to go with a Soul Siphon. Actually getting Arteezy kind of low. May force him back. Three last hits. Or rather, three right clicks. Getting down below half health. Now Invoker getting closer and closer to those shoes. We'll pick up the brown boots relatively soon. And that means more movement speed, more escape potential. So Death Prophet, she's going to have a nice time in lane. I don't think she gets killed, but she may not be able to look for any more aggro on Invoker.
And it looks like they've already given up on this aggressive tri-lane. Hesta Joe is now solo up here, as the other supports are heading towards mid. So they're going to try and shut down Arteezy this game. I guess they decided it's a bit of an easier go than the Terror Blade top. We'll see how that works out for them. But once again, Eternal Envy going to be having some good free farm time here. And Eternal Envy still getting a lot. Despite his death, he's actually ahead of the Death Prophet. Well played to him.
Yeah, he's definitely getting a lot out of this. And I mean, if that continues, Arteezy just brings so much to the mid game. He can scale up tremendously. And not to say Death Prophet becomes flimsy by any regards, but Baby Knight's only going to have that exorcism once every couple of minutes. And that means her fight potential is limited. Now, Noya, he's going to go in very deep here. We'll be able to roll away, but gets netted up. Nice creep play. He's going to get stuck in place. The Cold Snap coming through. A couple more hits should do it, but there is going to be that fairy fire keeping him alive. Now, Puppy going to get drained down, but has not fallen. The Crypt Swarm going to be slightly off the mark. And now, Puppy scraping by with 40 HP will be alive up top. We've got another initiation going down. It's EE going to be taking the Burrow Strike to the face. There is going to be the Sandstorm, but no way to hold him in place. So Terror Blade gets back low. It seems like everyone on Secret getting a scare, but not dropping just yet.
Yeah. Oh, nice attempt to turn things around by Baby Knight. It would have been nice if he got the counter kill. But he does stay alive and doesn't get a kill, but is farming well in the lane still. And Arteezy, I mean, I'm curious to see what Arteezy goes for.
He's going to be going for living here, which is the biggest thing. They bring in Pylite Dive. It's actually going to be a duel under Tower Ace. No respect. It's going through. There will be a
Nice
stop. The duel does not go through. Death Prophet still does get the kill in Vengeful Spirit, but not resulting in any extra damage. Now, Ace, very, very low here. Do they have anything? Arteezy looking for something here. He does have that Cold Snap. Can he cast it off? He needs the fish, but they're able to go through with that neutral deny. Legion Commander gets what she wants out of that fight. She will not secure the extra damage, but does show off the first duel with style.
Yeah, and they really wanted to get Arteezy there, but unfortunately a little bit off the mark with that rotation, is scouted out. And if they'd gotten the dual damage, I would have said that was a pretty big win. But the fact that they didn't, even though they do get a hero and the Legion Commander does get denied, the fact that no dual damage comes out from that first attempt is still probably a win for Secret.
Absolutely, no. I mean, Invoker still getting a whole lot out of this lane. Death Prophet has started to outfarm him slightly, but Invoker definitely still getting the money he needs to build up the items he needs to rotate and teamfight when this comes to the middle game phase.
Yeah. Now, once again, though, I'm feeling like the problem for Danish Bears might be their supports level. Says engagement on mid.
Teasy, the Boulder Kick's not going to take effect. He actually goes through. They're turning this onto Rise. The tornado comes out. Will he live to hit the ground? He guts just his carcass falls out of the wind tunnel, and that's going to be a dead Phoenix. So Secret actually looking to turn this aggressively very early on. What seems like that lineup that might need time to come online, they are just rocking out with.
Yeah, the Klaus Wex decision this game was really smart from Arteezy, providing that control.
Oh, they're rolling in here. Bubba gets the drag, showing off that lasso. Ace in some serious trouble, taking a magic missile, getting munched down. Tries to go through and tries to heal up, but we're not going to be successful. Now Noya looking for something here. He's very, very low mana. Only has that boulder available in 5 seconds. Can they cancel the TP? They just burn him down. It's going to be two dead on the side of Danish Bears. Secret looking very good so far. And this is going to be EE getting a whole heck of a lot of farm here.
That was just a really smart rotation. You do not expect to see a Terrorblade rotating out of this free farm safe lane at 7.5 minutes in. That is just not what you do with this hero, but they use it. They use it with the lasso, and it takes Danish Bears completely by surprise, gets them two important kills, and probably a tower now.
All right, now Ace, he's back in again. He does have that duel at the ready. I mean, there's really no easy targets at this point because Secret, they're rotating so cohesively. In fact, they're deep here. Uh-huh. Invis Bulba going to scout out the other Flappy Bird on the map and Rise. He doesn't have the egg. He just ticked over to level 4. So they could go for a very nice initiation here if they want. Now Bulba is going to reveal himself to the Sentry Wards. They got to know something's going down.
He doesn't know that he's been spotted, though.
Yeah, I mean, they're going to look for something there. The right click will reveal it. Now, Bulba, he's just going to flap away. Do they have any lockdown here?
Yeah,
they're
going to
get
duel.
Stuck up. I mean, they do have duel if they need it. That's going to be a nice, easy win if they can get it. But Bulba, he's super survivable. The duel may expire. Oh. In fact, it does expire. Once again, Legion foiled by the tank ability of the Batrider. Good God. You don't expect him to be that tanky this early on. But he's got those stats, man.
He's gone for the Moon Meander build of the drums first. So not rushing that Blink Dagger. If he had just had the Tranquils there, he would have fed the duel damage. But because of that extra gauntlet and circlet, he's fine. And another duel failure for Ace.
Yeah, we talked about the importance. I mean, they are getting kills every time they go for the duels, but you're not scaling up the Legion in the most effective way. You gotta get that extra damage. That's why you pick the Legion.
Yeah, and as I was going to mention before that smoke rotation went down, once again, the problem with Danish Bears seems to be their support levels this game. We're looking at both supports on the side of Secret at level 5, whereas Danish Bears, they're sitting on 4 and 3. So those critical level 6s, those big teamfight ultimates, are going to be delayed once again. And I mean, they're not out of it yet. They still have time to catch up. But at this rate, if Secret are able to get a lot done in the next couple minutes, then maybe those ultimates come out a little bit too late to be super effective for the first couple of team fights.
Absolutely. I mean, you've still got your Earth Spirit level 3, like you were saying. That is just so not going to contribute a lot. Yeah, he's got those 2 points in Boulder Smash. He's got the Rolling Boulder, but you need his control to be 100% on point, and you just can't do that with only 3 levels to work with.
Yeah, and if Arteezy goes for an Orchid build this game, these supports are going to be such food for him. He may get gone on here. They are trying to rotate around on him. Ace really wants to use the duel on this Invoker, but they're not going to find it.
I mean, he's been bloodthirsty for the last couple of minutes. He's rotating well. He's going for those nice pickups. The problem is that Secret are just so ready for this. They are reading right through the strat. I mean, their second pick Terrorblade draft leaves nothing to the imagination, but they can read Danish Bears like a book.
Yeah, we're gonna go for some tower pressure here, but
Tornado catching on too. The EMP coming out as well. Arteezy, he's morphing up everything. He's got the cold snap at the ready too, but no one gonna continue the push, so it's gonna be Secret once again zoning back Danish Bears. And the longer this goes on, the more it favors Secret just because of that Terrorblade.
Yeah, and I mean, Ace, immediately any potential he has to gank is gone. The EMP hits him, now he's got to go back to base. He's got zero mana, is useless without it. And meanwhile, Terrorblade Illusions pushing down the tier 2.
It's getting real rough for Danish Bears real fast. I mean, it's a bit early to look at the net worth chart, but it's already going to be almost 3,000 gold in favor of Secret at just over 10 minutes in. Similar story with XP.
Yeah, I mean, Secret have just played around this Earth Spirit Phoenix combo so effectively. And I mean, they know it well. It's a meta pick. They know how to deal with it. They've played against it so many times. And that is really biting Danish Bears. They've not found success with their supports. They've not shut down EE or Arteezy, really. And they are the more early game focused lineup. They're kind of all in with this Legion Commander pick. Haven't got enough out of it just yet.
Now EE picking off a nice yummy Ancients deck here. He's got a couple of Thunderhides to work through, and he's picking off a lot of gold on that. He already has his Dragonlance, he's already got the Treads and the Four-Man Shield, and almost 1,500 gold on top of that. This is a very, very farm Terrorblade. He has had no pressure. He's gotten fed 2 kills already. It's almost Secret's time to shine, and it seems like, once again, Danish Bears, they just kind of missed the mark with their draft.
And Puppy now has a Midas flying out to him, so he's completely ready to go late game. He is not worried about what Danish Bears can do in the mid game, given how well that Secret start has been. He'll go for the late game farm and be ready to provide some extra damage with the rest of his team. Now, it looks like Danish Bears will be able to claim the mid tower, but it's a bit slow.
I mean, it's 12 minutes in, and that's the first exorcism and the first tower of the game. It's not like Danish Bears are claiming these unbelievably huge objectives.
You know, 3-man smoke rotation. They really want to get another duel on Ace. He's got his Blink Dagger. This will be the reveal. And they get some good vision down. Who can they find?
Everyone's staying very, very far back here. Very well played from Secret. They know something's afoot. They're waiting here in their safe zone where they've got a ton of vision at this choke point here near the Secret Shop. And now there's going to be a rotation in as they do bring in Ace. Ace is just going to walk headlong into our TP. They're going to go through. They will get the dual rise. Do a lot of damage with that burn. But okay, swap out. Ace is going to be the one actually victimized here. But nice epicenter. Rip and thread when the egg coming out from the Phoenix is actually doing a lot of work. The egg will go down. But they do take out our TP. Vengeful Spirit sitting at almost no health. But Baby Knight going through, dragged on three sides. 2 Soul Siphons. Lasso. She'll end up going down as well. Hesta Joe Rotten is the only survivor here, blinking into the trees. Doesn't have enough mana for the TP, just has to sit there and wait. As maybe they think he's already gone, but they're gonna ping him out. Oh god. No, they can't afford a full wipe here, but they don't have much of a choice. Hesta Joe cornered into the trees, Enchantress ripping him apart with those impetus shots. So that's gonna be Danish Bears taking a full wipe. 13 minutes in the game. They sacrificed their Venge, and Invoker does go down, but still, certainly worth it. Looking at the fight recap, that's going to be a decent chunk of gold and a huge chunk of XP going in favor of Secret, and overall Spike is just, it's starting to really decline.
It was a nice attempt, and if the Death Prophet had been there to follow up the damage of that Echo, or of that, sorry, Epicenter with the, Exorcism, then they could have actually wiped Secret. It was a really nice initiation, but unfortunately, the Death Prophet had already used Exorcism mid. That spell wasn't available, and they were hoping to only find one or two heroes, but instead they find the entire Secret lineup. The duel fails once again. They get no damage out of that, and Pylad died there with the swap save. So they do lose Archeezy, but still well worth it to get a 5-man wipe. And Danish Bears, we already talked about how their timing was already starting to feel like it was missed. Now that is even more the case. Noya, it's 14 minutes in and he still does not have level 6 on this Earth Spirit.
Oh boy, he's trying though. He's rolling around, but yeah, it's getting steeper and steeper. And again, Danish Bears, they've got to make this work or they are right back down to the bottom. Secret, they can taste the victory here. They are so ready to go in and execute. And EE rips apart another tower here. He's picked himself up that Yasha, going to go for the Manta soon. And I mean, he's almost got it here at 14 minutes in. Just a couple hundred more gold and that's his.
Yeah, now Baby Knight on the Death Prophet is sitting at 5.9k. So net worth, not terrible, but up against a Terrorblade who's got this much. Baby Knight, I really fear that he's not going to be able to use his Exorcism successfully. He's going to die too quickly. They've got more than enough damage, especially if they get a lasso onto him from Bulba. And yeah, without that Exorcism, they just lose every single fight. That's the only way they can take a successful engagement.
Yeah, so it seems like Secret, they're ready to fight whenever, wherever they need to. They've got Invoker, who has a reasonably sustainable mana pool at this point. Got the Terrorblade, who just needs to like hit E, and you're good to go. You know, impetus shots from the Enchantress should be abundant, like plenty of them are ready to go. But whereas Danish Bears, they're so ultimate focused, you can't fight without the Egg, you can't fight without the Exorcism, you don't want to fight without the Sand King ulti either. So it's much trickier for Danish Bears to find these initiations, because Secret are going to be ready whenever you take it to them.
And Archeezy going back for a Midas. He's already got the gloves about 100 gold off.
Yeah,
and
why not?
Full greed. Yeah, why
not? I mean, the later this game goes, the more it favors Secret, so there's no benefit to kind of pausing out the items now.
Exactly.
Or rather, no backlash. There is
yeah.
a benefit.
They still feel like they can take a team fight, even with 4,000 of their net worth being invested in these Midases. And Puppy now happily farming up in the woods. I wonder what he's going to go for next. Potentially the Dragonlance again, although we could potentially see a Force Staff to try and deal with the duel a little bit.
I mean, the duel hasn't been that much of a problem.
No, it really hasn't.
Like, three successful duels, but Legion Commander is still sitting on no bonus damage, and like you mentioned, she has the blink, but with 1,000 more gold to go, she hasn't been able to itemize as effectively as she wants to versus the Terror Blade, her counterpart at the position one, who's, again, very, very close to that Mantis style on top of a first item already.
It looks like it'll be a smoke play from Secret. Bulba and Pilot Eye looking for a lasso target. They did just pick up the blink on the bat, and they'll catch it right away.
Baby Knight, no chance to react here. Just going to get completely plunked down. That's going to be an exorcism not used. I mean, smart, because Death Prophet would have died right away. But still, she's out of the fight for 40 seconds. She does have buyback, but it's 17 minutes in. You don't want to have to play that defensively at this point. Now the tier 2, rather the tier 1,
on the back
might
side.
End up going down. And there is a duel on the back line, but are they really going to get down Arteezy before the duel ends? No. The duel's over. Arteezy may still be dead. In fact, will be dead. But once again, Ace not getting anything beneficial out of that trade.
And that was a buyback on the Death Prophet. Baby Knight bought back for that. I don't really know why.
I mean, didn't even get all the way into lane. Just kind of walked through.
His TP's on cooldown. Did he try and TP out and fail somehow?
I don't know. I mean, he didn't have an impact in that fight, didn't go through and cast Exorcism. Maybe they're looking, because of that pickoff, to go and push now with the Exorcism, but they're still playing from the defensive standpoint, looking at the overall net worth. It's going to be tipping over 7,500. I think this game is firmly in Secret's paws.
Well, it's never over till it's over. We've got some time yet, but Eternal Envy with 3.7k on top of the Dragonlance means that even if it's not over, you're quaking in your Danish Bear's bootsies, as they're going to have a really hard time getting back into this. Now, Baby Knight does have a Veil of Discord and another 1,400 gold. If he can maybe find himself some kind of tank, I honestly wouldn't mind just seeing a Vit booster on him. He needs some way of surviving these fights, but... the push is coming in top lane from just the Illusions, while the rest of the team farms up in both jungles. Arteezy actually on the hunt, looking for a pick with that Ghost Walk, but not going to find anything just yet. Still, he knows that they're not in their own jungle, so this maybe reveals potential DB rotation. As they are grouping up, do they go for another smoke play? No, they don't have one. Never mind, Earth Spirit's got one, but... okay, it looks like they're going to group up. This is going to be the attempt. If they can find a good smoke rotation and can find an important pick, maybe they can start getting themselves back into this game. But they are being scouted. Creeps in the area, keeping an eye on things.
I mean, it's such a desperate spot right now. You've got Danish Bears going for a full five-man smoke, looking for something here, crawling back through, and they're going to be going
up. Look at Secret, though. Counter smoke. They read this so well.
I mean, they're playing so defensive. I mean, they're playing so smart. They're counter smoked up. They know that it's their chance to go aggressive. Again, Secret are ready at any
time to
take
a fight.
Terminal
Envy, though, could be caught. Oh, the smoke breaks. He knows they're there and immediately backs off.
There's going to be a blink in, though. They get the Veil here, but EE, no remorse. Just go and chuck it through with that new BKB. Puppy might end up melting down here. This could be the ulti from Baby Knight doing a little bit of work here, but not zoning out Eternal Envy at all. Another drag back through. They get the kill onto the Phoenix. Both supports are dead. Baby Knight could be the last hope here. He can't afford to go down here. Arteezy fighting into the Exorcism. Finally, the swap away will mean another unsuccessful duel. Fantine gets the kill onto the Enchantress, and now Ace will end up going down in the end. Baby Knight not going to live to hit the ground. Just get tornadoed up and dropped. Now Sand King goes. It's a complete wipe. Secret may end up taking this game right here, right now, doubling up the kill score. That fight recap looks dirty there. 2k XP swing continuing to go in Secret's favor.
The good news is that the swap from Pi came out just a second too late, as Legion did get the dual damage. Now up to 14. So yay, I guess.
She got one.
She got one. She doesn't end the game with no duels. That would be embarrassing. But yeah, pretty disastrous. They only get Puppy on the Enchantress, who really doesn't care. He's got that Midas rolling, so we'll stay ahead. And Eternal Envy being involved in multiple kills. He's now 6-0-6 at the 20-minute mark. 12k net worth, doubling up both of his opponents, more or less, and...
EE might end up just denying to neutrals here. Finally got Pilot Eye tanking, so he's got to be very careful here. I mean, there's no Sun Strikes that they're ready from the enemy team, but yeah, he's playing with fire, but he can absolutely afford to do so. I'm actually pretty surprised the Roshan hasn't been a bigger point of contention so far.
Yeah, Secret can go for it with that minus armor at the Vengeful Spirit when they want to, but they haven't really felt a need to do so. Right now, they're finding so much out of the map, and I imagine that is going to be your next play for them, but they're not really feeling in any rush. Like we already talked about, they're content letting this game go late, as their advantage is only going to get bigger.
Yeah, absolutely. And
oh
right.
boy,
what?
Fusil Blade on the Terrorblade.
Oh god, he is ready to just go in and rip the Band-Aid off, just tear apart Danish Bears. And I mean, he's now got the tools to do so. Looking at the overall net worth, it is spiraling down almost 14,000 in favor of Secret XP. Very similar story there. And if Danish Bears were to get this off, it's going to be on the back of a very farmed Legion Commander, and she's doing all right. She's got some decent 15 minutes items, but we're 21 minutes in and she needs that damage, which just isn't coming out. Her team's really tried to set those duels up for her, but they just can't hold heroes in place long enough.
Yeah, they don't have any follow-up damage to the duel. All of their damage is over time. The Phoenix, the Earth Spirit, and the Death Prophet, their damage is, none of it is burst. So that means if the Legion doesn't have a good start, then it's really hard for them to bring heroes down in that duel timing.
So was this just a bad Legion pick, or, you know, what went wrong here? Because it seemed like Danish Bears were so confident about this.
Well, Ace has had 4 or 5 duels now. If he'd gotten them off, there were a couple that were so close in the early game. If he'd had that bonus damage, maybe things are better. But, yeah, I don't know. He got a lot of farm early on, but that has completely dropped off. His 4 deaths haven't helped either. I'm not sure I'm comfortable calling it a bad Legion game. I could see what they're going for here, but the execution just wasn't there. Now they're being backstabbed. Secret, ready with the wraparound.
If this is another wipe, it could be GG right here, right now. Noya gonna be revealed. He's gonna be taking a defusal charge. He's just gonna be controlled up, slapped down. Eternal Envy just absolutely playing dirty. Now Ace gonna get completely creamed. Can't even find the duel. There's gonna be a TP out. Everyone just getting dragged around. Triple kill for EE right now. 3 heroes fallen. Danish Bears, this may be the end. This may be Danish Bears starting back from zero in the open qualifiers soon. Secret are looking so strong right now. They have never looked better as a team. I mean, in this game.
In this
open qualifiers run.
Okay, fair enough. I was going to say, I'm pretty sure.
I mean,
them...
the fact that they're in open qualifiers means maybe they've looked better as a team at some point, but right now, they are definitely playing cohesively. They found that sparkle, man.
They really have. This is looking strong. And I mean, I know they're playing against not top-tier teams. Danish Bears, I don't want to throw shade.
Oh no, Death Prophet just trying to find some farm. He's going to go through double soul siphon. She's twisting around. She's back at full health, but it's not going to last. They bring in the Phoenix. Baby Knight actually surviving this. A decent amount being healed up by every possible source. Now Noya going through. We'll cast that dust. Bulba actually in a little bit of trouble taking a solo magnetize. And it looks like Phoenix is trying to find something. Your Puppy actually the one getting low now, but Rise.
Nice stun.
A little too ambitious here. Goes for the egg. Puppy, he's burning. He falls. The egg will go through. Will be clean. Now Arteezy, he's magnetized out. Do they have any more vision for him? Looks like the dust was already popped by the Earth Spirit, so they've got nothing else. Arteezy lucky to be alive, so that was Danish Bears actually turning around, showing some signs of life, but they only got the offlaner and the Enchantress, not the big pick they were looking for.
They'll get a tower tool too, so that's a bit of gold going their way. And if they found the Envy Terrorblade, they'd probably just actually die, because he's got BKB. He would just would have turned on them with the Aegis. So maybe they're just happy that those are the heroes they find and get. A little bit of gold going their way. And the Death Prophet actually passes the Invoker. So has a Yule Scepter, has some survivability with that, and has the Exorcism back off cooldown. Maybe they can use this to make a play.
Yeah, I mean, they've got to go now or never, because the later this goes, the scarier it is. You've got to really start scaling up that Legion, who is still only holding on to that one duel victory.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Oh yeah, 25-minute Midas Phoenix. You know, I've seen later, and it's going to be wildly successful. Phoenix, thankfully, one of those heroes that doesn't need the Midas ASAP. As long as he gets it at some point, he'll keep up with levels.
Yeah, and he has managed to find his level 11, so doing a lot better in that regard than he did last game. Eternal Envy, though, farming up
another
ancient stack.
This is going to be another quad stack for him. This is like the zillionth ancient he's taken. These black dragons causing no trouble, just letting his illusion do the dirty work now. And over here could be a gank here. Arteezy, he's invist up, sticking around, and he's saving up a big sum of pennies here. What's he going for next?
Probably the axe. It's almost certainly the build here. If he wanted an orchid, he would have gone for it before the four staff, and axe just so much utility on the invoker. He's about to hit 16 as well, so that's the maximum spell spam combo.
I mean,
he's hiding in the trees.
He was looking there. He was trying to find Arteezy. He knew he was nearby because his footsteps were all cold and stuff. Now Arteezy going in with the cold snap. There's going to be the Icarus dive away, but Arteezy's speedy. He's diving past the tier 1. In fact, why is there a tier 1? There's a Terrorblade in this game.
He's been busy with other things.
Yeah, it's not going to be there for much longer.
Eternal Envy sees it now. Oh, did I still leave this up?
What?
My bad.
We've been pushing tier twos. May as well just take that one while it's up. And I mean, Terrorblade's still sitting there. He's still got an 8-second BKB at the ready, so he's ready to fight at any given moment. And he's saving up 3k gold here. Now he's got that completed Mazda. What does he look for next?
Butterfly would be a nice choice. He could also go for the Boots of Travel, or maybe build his Hurricane Pike out of the Dragonlance. That's, I think, what he did last game, so...
Yeah, I mean, it's super strong. You get so much control. I mean, the Legion Commander looking to hold someone in place with Duel, but you can basically just hit your Hurricane Pike and have a very similar ability with oodles more damage. Now, EE, he's going to be going into that big boy form. He's got the BKB at the ready if he wants to get even bigger, and that's going to be a tier 3, just getting completely decimated there. There's no creeps helping him out. This is just him solo whacking at the tower.
Yeah, and he doesn't even use his illusions for the tower. He uses them to zone back the enemy team. Now taking some damage, but he's got the Aegis, remember, so not really too worried. Looking for the swap, but won't get it off.
Tower's got 7 HP. I think he can finish that off on his second life. And now he's coming back in. One hit with the BKB. He's actually looking to turn and fight. He wants to stay in here. He's got his team for backup. There's going to be a flapping Batrider around. Goes for the Flame Break. Maybe not actually getting up a nice ulti. Speaking of nice ultis, he's got a very nice swap coming in. Pylai die going through there. It's going to be a duel coming out. Ace gets burned down. No duel for him once again. There's going to be another kill coming out. If they do take out the Terrorblade, he's got buyback if needed, but that's a big kill. That's a Beyond God, or yeah, Beyond Godlike streak. Going the way of the Earth Spirit. Now Noya looks for more. It looks like he will find it. Death probably gets the kill for that with the Exorcism, so Baby Knight actually finding a lot of gold in that fight. That was 3 dead on Secret. They just got a very confident 4. It's not game losing, but Secret may need to tighten up their play just a little bit if they want to take this flawlessly.
They're still okay, but like you said, there was no actual reason for Terrorblade to just feed his Aegis like that. He could have backed up. Puppy's nearby with the heal, so he could have healed up to full and just gone back in, but maybe a little bit of impatience coming out from Secret. They do take the tower, but like you say, they give a lot of gold around. However, Terrorblade did win that duel. So, Envy with the bonus 14 damage. He's now got as much duel gold. He's got as much duel damage up as the Legion does.
That's unfortunate there, and you just look at Terrorblade's raw damage. He's already hitting for over 200 in Legion. Smacking for 150, and she's trying, man. She's got that blade mail, so she's going to be a little bit more effective in these fights, especially up against squishy heroes, like the Batrider goes for a lasso, dragging her over the fire, and the blade mail's up. He could be in some serious trouble.
It's a little slow, though. Ace, if he'd had these items 5 minutes ago, maybe then I would have felt like he could do something with it. But now it just feels like... I mean, they did just take a big fight. But that was on the back of Secret overextending a little bit. And the duel was on point for...
Oh, Arteezy gets bailed up. They know he's here. Could look for a pick or something on the back of this. It's okay. We got boulders kicking on in. There's going to be a roll back. Earth Spirit wants nothing to do with this dire stack pushing in. Secret. It seems like they're grouped up. They're kind of like, all right, we burned the Aegis. We made a couple mistakes. Let's make up for it with a good, clean push right now.
And Puppy has the eggs, so he is ready to be dealing damage. Didn't go for the Dragonlance this time. Just wants that raw right click. And he's about to hit level 16 as well. Only half a level away from it. So he is going to be a problem. If you focus the Terrorblade, then Puppy just kills you with rainbows.
Typical Puppy fashion there. And now up top we have some split push coming out. It's Ace actually sitting back waiting for someone to go and deal with this wave, I guess, but she's sitting out of XP range, she's sitting out of gold range, so Ace very, very scared. Appropriately so there. That's going to be Legion 1 and 6. And now there's going to be a wave cut here. I mean, they don't even need backdoor protection. Screw
They're just waiting for the creeps to come in the mid so they can take down these racks.
Yeah, I mean, he has that Metamorphosis at the ready if he needs it. And that's going to be a pretty big... a lot of damage coming out, a lot of push potential. And like you mentioned, the Ags on the Enchantress means you can kind of zone out anyone that goes and steps in front of them.
They actually do back. Just using an illusion to work on the melee racks, that's not the choice you want there.
I mean, it doesn't even matter though, because again, Secret aren't playing on a clock. It's not like, oh, on the other team you've got a Sven and a Tiny and all these heroes that scale up unbelievably well in the late game. Like, yeah, Legion can get huge. Death Prophet can hold on for a little bit, but not when you're already this far behind and not when you're playing up against a Terrorblade Invoker.
Yeah, and shout out to Baby Knight, by the way. Despite how badly his team is doing, 12 and 20 your kill score, he is still ahead of Eternal or Arteezy's Invoker. Yeah, he's up on him by about 1,000. So Death Prophet, not the greatest farmer from behind. He's doing quite well. He's almost got his full Octarine online, only needs 30 gold or so, although he probably wants to save the buyback.
I mean, he may just have to go full YOLO in, because if you already go through, if you already bust out that exorcism and there's nothing at the ready, what's the point of buying back? We already saw BabyNet with one less than successful buyback here, and we'll go for that Octarine, so I think that's the right choice. I think you got to have one Hail Mary play, because if your whole team goes down and you buy back, there's still no damage left to take the fight.
Agreed, agreed. It's the right call. And with that item, that's a pretty big pickup. Maybe that will finally enable them to take a big team fight. But at the same time, on the other side of things, Arteezy grabs himself a Scotty.
Oh, boy.
Now sitting on 2.3k HP as well as 35 armor.
Do you mean EE? Because I'm pretty sure you mean EE.
Did I say Arteezy?
You did.
Dang it.
It's all right, man. They're both big old secret players.
They both have two E's in their name. No, they don't. Arteezy just rhymes with EE. That's my problem. Guys, it's been a long day. Don't give me flack.
You're going to get so much flack there. You're
going to
get death threats tweeted to you. Have fun, man.
It's going to be great. I love me some Twitch chat. You guys are all awesome. Send me the hate. It looks like it will be a push in top. Danish Bears looking for a go onto this tower, and they may actually be able to get it. I don't think Secret bother rotating back. Instead, they're just going to go for the push into the bottom lane.
I mean, they don't really care, because look at the push potential coming out of Danish Bears. It's going to take them an exorcism if they want to actually commit to this, and that means Secret, they go through, they bring the Terror Blade, and there's just so much raw damage. They know Danish Bears are going to have to rotate to save their racks, because they can't afford to get mega'd.
They really can't. Against the Terror Blade, as soon as you lose one lane of racks, the next are short to follow.
Absolutely,
looks like,
man.
Secret hovering around the high ground, they really want to break the smoke. And they will.
Oh, there's going to be the bench here. No, something's coming. Nice tornado from Arteezy. Once again, everything's dropping down. They will pop the exorcism, so Baby Knight has to commit to this fight. There's a big ult already spent. EMP zoning everyone back. Phoenix leaping away. EMP not going to catch out. They will get the duel here onto Puppy. That's going to be more damage going the way of the Legion Commander. You got a second one there. Well played, Ace. Well played. And now it looks like they're looking for more here. Blink forward by Hesta Joe. Looks like Burrow Strike. He could get it. Oh, double Burrow Strike coming in. But there's going to be everything shooting at Hesta Joe. He is going to be swapped up. Snaps back, he's gonna be dragged through the flames. He's gonna go through, he drops everything he's got, and now Terror Blade is gonna be just going through, ripping apart the Death Prophet as well. And now Death Prophet, like we said, does have buyback, as she saved up a bunch
but
of ults
no
in the last couple of pushes.
Exorcism.
Oh yeah, that's gonna be a dead everyone, basically. The only survivors are gonna be the Phoenix and the Legion Commander, but they're both cowering, they're both running back to the base, they can't take this alone. And you've got a Terror Blade in the Metamorphosis form, ready to go through and rip apart your racks. There will be a buyback from the Sand King. He has his ult at the ready, this could be huge, it could be enough to zone heroes back, but again, Secret, they go in, they get what they want, and they can back off safely. There's no reason to push this, there's no reason to overextend. Hop back into Roche, grab yourself an Aegis and continue the strangle.
This is just death by a thousand cuts. Secret, they're so patient. They force out the buyback, they just, okay, fine, you buy back, you go ahead, you won't get anything out of it, we'll get a Roche out of it, and we'll come back later once Metaphor is back up. They've got a window of 30 seconds where Death Prophet still does not have Exorcism, so maybe they look to take advantage of it, or, you know, maybe they just delay the game for another 20 minutes and make sure the Terror Blade's 10-slotted.
All right, yeah, I mean, they could do that. I think Secret know that the sooner they get this over, the sooner they're done with their journey through the open qualifiers, and they are ready to just sit back, relax, and get a day off. And, you know, Danish Bears, we've said it a couple times now, they have got a long road ahead, having to start all the way from whence they came. Do you think they can do it again? Do you think they can grind back up? Or, you know, will strong teams like Polarity and Kaipe be able to take it off them?
Well, that's the thing, right? It's best of ones. So even if you're a strong team, even if you're one of the best teams, all it takes is one cheese strat, one thing you weren't expecting, one draft loss, and you can be done. So Danish Bears, they definitely have the potential to get here, as they've already shown, but there's no guarantee that they'll be back for day two. We'll see how they can do. It's not over yet, though. I want to say Eternal Envy could get aggressive on the high ground and expect to be able to get a Sunder off and not do it. He could, you know, if he feeds, that's a lot of gold going Danish Bear's way. Maybe they come back.
I mean, last time he died, he dropped well over 1,000 golds straight to the Earth Spirit. But, and again, what does an Earth Spirit really do? He goes through and he grabs a Force Staff. Man, he's got that mobility. Yeah. But it's still underwhelming here. Again, looking at the overall deficit, it's going to be still 15,000 holding tight to that curve. You know, experience is kind of coming back in favor of Danish Bears, but Secret then pulling it back forward with this lane push. And the fact that Danish Bears are confined to their base means they just aren't finding those levels.
Yeah. And there are still two Midases rolling on the Dire side. Oh, Tornado catches onto Ace, but he will be okay. Arteezy just poking. for now.
I mean, there's no reason for Secret to rush. We've said that sometimes they can be a bit impatient as a team, but again, it feels like in this game, they found their spark. They realized, you know what, we can establish ourselves once again as a tier one team if we play cohesively, play together, and that's what they're doing here. They're showing a lot of restraint, taking smart fights, and it's really working out. There's been a lot less feeding going on.
Yeah. I think EE just likes hitting creeps, man. I think he said to Puppy, look, I'm having a good time here. Can't we just delay this out till an hour? I want to up my creep score. Got to pad those stats.
Those fantasy points rolling, man.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. It looks like the push will finally come in, but he's being a lot more patient with it now, just sending in the illusions rather than using his own hero. He's still got the Aegis, but we saw how he could lose that last fight or last push. So going to be slow with it now. They're keeping all of Danish Bears back inside their base. And very, very patient play.
I mean, they're waiting for Danish Bears to step out to clear the wave. They're waiting for something. Now Bulba going through has that blink force, is looking for something here, has the gem as well. Very deep commit here. If he drops the gem, that could be pretty sour, as Invoker has been relying on
the ghost. Here comes the alacrity push, though. Holy crap, that damage.
EE is just... Oh my god, he's hitting with rapier tier damage right now, and doesn't even have the rapier. You know, he could go for it. He's sitting at like 4k gold on top of buyback. We'll have to see how YOLO Secret go.
Yeah, why bother? You can just buy a butterfly and be completely unstoppable.
Oh my, he's hitting through the sun, right? He does not care. Now, there is going to be a little bit of a back, but once again, the alacrity means he is just ready to go through and shred. There will be a nice stun. Burrow Strike coming through. EE again does have the Aegis.
Oh,
we're
the
repeat blast, and the thunder comes out. Baby Knight casting the exorcism, but it might be too late. EE is just too large, and there's going to be Baby Knight getting dragged out, brought down. The buyback is there if she needs it, but again, there's no exorcism. What other damage is there? Oh, the really incredible epicenter, but it won't get anyone down. Team Secret, they're half health. They're still full of pep, and that's going to be a full lane of racks. Now, EE doesn't need to stop there. He doesn't have that metamorphosis form, but he's still got the damage. The alacrity means he's hitting fast, hitting hard, and this may be it. A second lane of racks going their way. Ryze, he has the egg, but that's going to be the last thing.
Now, Baby Knight buys back. He gets it.
Okay, Arteezy is down. A is hitting a little bit harder now. There's going to be double soul siphons off as Pylai Dai does go down. Baby Knight, though, getting chunked by Puppy. Bulba coming back in. Has that flame break at the ready if they need it. Will pop back. And now, Puppy, super, super low. Will end up going down. There's going to be a Sunstrike. Not going to connect onto Baby Knight. Baby Knight actually still alive somehow, but this is a dieback. If she does go down, she's out for 100 seconds. And that's going to be a very, very dangerous thing. EE has joined the fight once again, still holding up the Aegis. And he's hitting hard. He's hitting those creeps, man. He loves it. And Ace is going to get plummeted down. Another BKB charge actually popped out, so when Terrorblade comes back, he doesn't have that magic immunity, but everyone
doesn't
else
matter.
Is dead. The
yeah,
GG comes out. Team Secret will be your first open qualifier winners. They're going to be moving on here to the regionals, going up against some of the best teams in Europe to fight for a spot in TI6, the largest gaming LAN in history, or shaping up to be at least. Danish Bears drop right back down. They're going to be starting their journey all over again tomorrow right here on this channel.